Good morning, YouTube friends. It's Joyce from Morris Patch of Heaven Homestead. It's a wonderful dewy day this morning in the Midwest. Everything's wet. It's starting to feel like fall, but we're still in the midst of summer. We have something new on the homestead, and I wanted to share it with you. Okay, let's go around back. Come on. As you can tell, the grass is really, really wet. We don't have to water today, at least not for a while. Come look at my pumpkin flowers here. I'm so excited. Hopefully we will have pumpkins for pie. Look at how beautiful they are. I love in the morning when they're wide open and you can see them. They're doing so good, but that's not what I have to share with you. What's new on the homestead is, check it out, five pot-belly pigs. Some friends of ours that are moving out of state gifted us with these five pigs. As you can tell, we have a jungle here, and we're hoping that these guys are going to help us keep the jungle down. A lot of this is burdock. If y'all are not familiar with burdock, it is highly sought after for Chinese medicine. I'm going to tell you some of the benefits, and you know, it's a wonderful medicinal plant. And we're happy to have it on our homestead, but in moderation, we don't want as much as we have. I wrote down because I wanted to make sure that I got it exactly right, what it was good for, because it is such an amazing plant. And you know, it's called burdock for a reason. It's got these little burrs, and they get stuck on your clothes, they get stuck in animal fur, and they just get traveled all over the place. So somehow we ended up with some on our property a few years ago, and since then it has just turned into this enormous jungle. This here is not burdock that you're seeing, but the burdock is all over in the back, and it is spread like crazy, like wildfire. Our animals, I think our dogs have taken it, and we have it everywhere. But anyway, I wanted to tell you some of the benefits because it is amazing. So, you know, having it on the homestead in a small amount wouldn't be so bad. Let's take a close look here. Here's one. Here's a burdock plant right here. And I wanted to show you the burr. As you can tell, there's fur on here from one of our animals. And what happens is these burrs here will, you know, once they're dried out, will attach themselves to the animal's fur. And here's a burdock plant. And it will just go all over and just start anew. And this here area right here that you see has been completely knocked down because this was all burdock. And like I said, in small doses, it can be a good thing. Here's some that's dried out right here. These are the burrs that attach themselves and just get spread everywhere. So we literally have burdock growing all over. But I wanted to tell you some of the benefits, because it is a good plant to have, or it's something that you might think of picking up at the health food store because of its benefits. Like I said, it's very highly sought after for Chinese medicine. They just prize it because they call it a super herb, I guess you'd say. It regulates blood pressure. I mean, blood pressure. It regulates blood pressure by taking that. Hi, guys. Oh, my goodness, you dumped your water. We need to get some water. It aids in digestion. Everybody has digestive issues from time to time, and it aids in that. It controls diabetes. I mean, how wonderful to think that an herb that God created can control our diabetes. It detoxifies the liver. All of us need to do a liver detox from time to time because of all the foods that we eat and stuff. In this day and age, our liver is overworked, and we need to do that like a cleanse. You know, maybe every 6 months to year, do a liver cleanse, and this detoxifies it. It also is very good for your skin. See, if your liver is faulty, you will find that you have acne and different skin issues, you know, dried out skin problems like eczema and psoriasis and different things like that can be an issue with the liver. And also it promotes hormone balance. And you know, when your hormones aren't balanced properly, you can have too much estrogen, maybe not enough estrogen, and it just causes a bunch of havoc in your body when your hormones are not in balance. But this herb can control and, you know, bring that back into balance. It boosts your immunity, which is wonderful. You know, again, we need to make sure that our immune system is healthy so that when things come our way, that it will fight it off on its own. I see a spider web, probably from that tree all the way down here. It's hilarious how they can just spin it clear across the yard. Anyway, it is full, packed full of minerals. We need minerals, because in our soil anymore, minerals are hard to find. Years ago, you know, our soil was rich in minerals. And so when we grew our vegetables and stuff, a lot of the minerals came into our vegetables. But our soil is so depleted of minerals that we have to try to find it else, you know, elsewhere. But burdock is one of those that is full of minerals. It has calcium, potassium, magnesium, phosphorus, selenium, vitamin C, B, E, K, and it is chock full of amino acids. That's just to name a few. I knew if I didn't write down, I wouldn't remember them all. But anyway, I just wanted to share the benefits of burdock. It may not be something you want to grow in your yard, but it may be something that you can, that would help you with some ailments. And it might be something that you want to grow. And if so, I can send you some seeds because we have plenty. But it's just one of those things that I really wanted to share with you. And I wanted to show you the new additions to the homestead. These five, it seems that there's four here. One is probably busy eating. We just fed them. And of course, as you can tell, they've already knocked down a whole bunch. This was full yesterday. And we're so excited to have them just as foragers to just help us keep things down on the homestead. These are not pigs that you eat. These are just pigs that you either keep around as pets. They're very friendly. They love to be pet. Actually, it's funny when you think of petting a pig, but they like that. The friends that we got them from treated them as pets, so therefore they are pets. Sometimes pigs you would think are just for meat. These are not. We do have, had mule-footed pigs last year, and they have since gone into the freezer because those were for meat. But these guys we're keeping around as pets and foragers, so it should be kind of fun. You might get to see them walking around the homestead from time to time, because as they get used to their surroundings, we're thinking that we might let them forage in different areas as well. But we just were blessed by our friends to get these, and so I just wanted to share that with you. And I hope you enjoyed seeing them. And again, I will show them to you from time to time. And I hope that you have a blessed day. And until next time, God bless you.